already contending with a whole lot, and my goodness, there's bloodshed everywhere. This mid push has been quashed a little. Magisk has got more to trifle with, and he doesn't really have the health or the bullets for it. My God, that was a quick start to our series. Hello. How you doing?
Blink and you miss it. But yeah, that was the pistol round, and maybe that'll set the tone here for the rest of the game. 1x bet odds at the top of your screen favoring the princes and not the kings of Denmark. That title, I'm sure, is one that Heroic are going to want to claim, well, in this whole rebuilding phase.
It's a heavy crown that Astralis have been wearing for far too long, those kings. But definitely changing up a bit of their roster. I can't keep up with this whole medieval monarchy conundrum, but... yeah, it's definitely a period of transition. Lots of conversation to be had about it. We are into our second round. Astralis investing with Kevlar and Deagles, and now they lay on the floor of Banana, thanks to Refresh's handiwork. More, in fact, this time it's down. Famas, the perfect weapon for that long range fight, and pushing to finish it. Refresh with some push and some pizzazz, leaving Dupree's Deeg with it all to do.
Be good if he gets more than one here, but. Maybe the easiest of tasks. The bomb down over towards Banana. He's been given all the room that he would like to maneuver around towards apartments as dropping back towards library is shush.
Heroic are going to be playing like this, though, until Astralis stop him, right? I mean, admittedly, this is on the bonus rifles, and I know Refresh has just... I wanted to address it now, is that I've noticed, that Refresh has got a lot more pep in his step than what we saw over in Cologne in terms of the fights he's willing to take. And that's often what we regarded as his strong suit. You know, he's willing to kind of subvert people's expectation and to take the outlandish play.
Yeah, I think it's for the majority of these names here, they are functioning at a much higher level than we saw from them in Cologne not that long ago. Tassus is back to his old form. I think Shush was one of the individuals in Cologne for Heroic that impressed me and is still doing the same type of impact that we are seeing here. Here's Dupree just working on whatever magic he can. 25 seconds left and down he goes. Tassus finishes that one off and it should be the full eco now from Astralis. So these SMGs, the two MP9s in the hands of Tassus, and I think Refresh is scuffling his across to Cadian right now. They can farm up a bunch more cash the next round to play, round number three. But yeah, this whole group stage, as you've heard from the desk, as I'm sure you've probably seen on social media, is pretty much tied up, right? We'll keep that as the ancillary storyline. We'll keep the main storyline for this evening. Who's the best team in Denmark right now? Now, most of us would say Heroic, and I'm sure Astralis don't want that to be the constant conversation. So playing for pride. Holding off on the bridge there, so hoping to use the Glocks if anybody wanted to go too aggressive, taking a peek in the second mid, trying to use those SMGs to farm on up. Not necessarily the angle that you're ready for three Ts to be stacked in.
Yeah, I don't think there's any doubt as well when you watch Heroic play that they are, at this point in time, the most threatening from Denmark. There's no disputing that. Astralis definitely have proven that they are still capable of shaking up the dialogue as they did in Cologne. I mean, a third, fourth finish, well above that of Heroic and even winning the head-to-head.
Isn't it crazy, though, they get that third, fourth finish on LAN, and then, like, and that was with Bobski in play, right? And then they've decided, oh, yeah, well, we'll just bring Lucky in and we're going to put Zipex basically on the bench
on
here.
On ice.
Yeah, and... Oof, all right, the Deagle from Dupree, it lands again, so... Two rounds in a row, it's been able to close out at least with a frag. One to find right now, it's just Glaive pushing up short, and, well, Refresh's Deagle works just as well. Lovely shooting from him, 7 kills already for Refresh. So, off to a bit of a blinder in the early stages, Heroic. What have they conceded? A total of... five deaths. So
yeah, he's a badass. Not only did he get the multi-kill in the pistol, he then threw his SMG away, said, I don't even need the Deagle, and gets another double, make it triple, excuse me, with the Desert Eagle. So yeah, solid start from Refresh, 7 under the belt already, and we get to see Astralis stepping into the reins of their first full assault. We get to see the AWP actually being pulled out by Lucky. Wonder what responsibilities he's going to take.
Not easy with that T side at all.
They had 4 players B-side. They won a biff. And that biff, so far, has netted them a frag. Resmoking that top banana, it's theirs. Heroic have it full control, and top mid smoke still. It fades right before our eyes, and Refresh and Cadian should be back to back up Shush in time. So solid start from Heroic in terms of just maneuvering around this map. Testing for the mid control.
Yeah, they're really gonna have to work hard to find another frag. Yes, just stalling out with more utility right now are Heroic, and back and forth this pendulum of Astralis will swing. They've done testing the waters of top mid and are heading back towards Banana. have a bunch of smokes, a couple of flashes, and this AWP of Lucky here could catch a jumping Tessess towards the top. Flashed off, and Tessess will think better of it. Holding onto his smoke now. We have sub 1 minute, and there's the frag. So Dupree with the opener, and Cadian with the trade.
Yeah, Refresh is going to accelerate into the rotate as well. Good time to drop his smoke. They might try and disrespect it. It's Glaive starting to push through. He is going to go for the full commit. Tessess loses vision. Refresh ready to contest. And good find from the first and a swing out to finish. Magnificent from Heroic. Very responsive and a very quick CT fourth.
That's one of the things that's become synonymous with Heroic, right? Is these mid-round decision-making, how quick all of the members are reactive to either different information or the calls that Cadian's making, especially on the T sides. It's something that we've enjoyed, especially the fakey boys, right? And that's only really made possible by them all trusting in the call and believing and responding immediately. But you bang on there with the top, with the four players towards top banana. This banana control, right? Guys, it looks like they're just throwing nades in banana, but it's really, really not that simple. The different routines that the Ts or CTs can throw to try and get control, it's very scissor, paper, rock in that elk.
And it's safe to assume it's no coincidence that Heroic did the four players banana full control on the first buy round of Astralis.
Kind of sets the tone, doesn't it? Especially with those bonus weapons in play. And now another opener here for Heroic is they're working on their fifth round. Flash forwards down. Don't catch any frags just yet, but there's even more utility holding Astralis behind this half wall. That smoke negates their molly, control completely denied.
Ooh, you've done it again, dude.
We're deja vu in a lot of these rounds with Dupree and the Deagle.
Every time we cut to him, shout out to the Obs team for catching his funny business. Now, Refresh did catch a glimpse of a barrel and we'll get more than just a barrel. It's four in one mag.
He gets the ace.
It's a 4-5 in total. That is a brutal dispatch of the Deegs from the Danes.
What a start for him. As per our little stat line here, what is it, 249 ADR. That's the opener. This is the perfect lineup. This is what you dream of here when you're playing in trash.
He doesn't even let go. Glaive just steps into the laser beam.
Lovely, lovely.
And that's going to do wonders for his confidence. Whole team, whole room erupting for his play. He's going to be feeling very hot. 13 already, and Refresh is off for a push.
Oh, they're not stopping.
He's got an AK.
Pain.
Yeah, he wants to make this hurt. Bubsky's responsibility. The flash is perfect from Stown, all the way from downtown.
And Cady will combo.
Dunk on another. He's cleared banana. They got banana control through mid, dude. Magic has to retake it from here. And now Shush is off for a push.
Oh, this is naughty. They are bullying Astralis here.
No, just as he looks the wrong way, Magic is in trouble. Does react in time. Oh, man. Heroic. They have got their foot firmly on the accelerator here.
Let's just see how far they want to push the issue, because Cadian, I can't believe it. He's actually having a look down middle here. They had a two-man advantage. Sure, one's been clawed back, but this is a Heroic round to lose right now. How many more pushes do they want to go for? The reaggression from Tessess here. He's creeping down. He's about to call second mid clear. Cadian and Stown are already over towards the B bomb site. Shush can get a move on now that that door has been locked firmly behind them.
Yeah, Tessess just screaming at him, saying, I got the mid rotate. You can go. And Cadian just says no. Glaive not going to be able to get anything on his initial swing of banana. And that leaves us in a very tight spot if you're Magisk and Lucky.
I feel like they want to save, but they're giving it a go here. Smoke's exchanged. Molly's going to be thrown out here as well. Lucky can't really just entry frag through this with an orb.
He's following him with his knife like, so what's up, dude? What's up?
Yes, boss.
Here they come, and there they go. Six for Heroic. And I mean, this is a very quick six. Like, I mean, these... Maybe we want to talk about a timeout. Astralis, it's running away from them. This is supposed to be a competitive first half of a full best of three. You've picked Inferno. And already it just seems like we have got the same Heroic that show up every single day so far here at Pro League.
They like Pro League, don't they?
They do.
Yeah.
They definitely do. I've seen this format of Heroic before, and it was season 13.
Well, let's keep tallies on Dupree and the Deagle. So far, so good. Can he do it again? It's going to be this four-man B lean once more out of Heroic. Setting Stown up for success. Working the presence over towards A.
That nade did so much damage.
Yikes.
Maths is hard. It's not my strong suit. 93.
93.
Yeah. 93 damage from a HE.
Imagine you sounded so confident.
Could you imagine if I sounded said that immediately? You know, like I was actually capable.
We can fix it in post.
We can?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Oh, so glad we're not doing anything live. That would be dreadful. Whatever you say, being immediately
broadcast to the world
and retained forever.
Yeah, it's not like the radio where they have that big red button. You know, they have got that like 5-second delay.
No,
and the
I'd love one of them.
Bang.
Cut that.
Well, here we go. Bit of damage done back to Stown, okay? So he's chipped on down to 40. Dupree's Deagle yet to strike, and we know so far he's been good for one. Walking into the crosshair, though, we just flicked away as Lucky took Tassus's head off.
Yeah, the ops team didn't believe in him. They didn't have faith.
Rushley, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sorry,
five,
boys.
Six.
Sorry about that.
He exists.
We can hear him.
That's cool. What? Why don't you trust him, eh? You haven't seen enough from Lucky?
I just wanted to show...
Is it the namesake?
Is he not cool enough for you?
I wanted to show Guardian rotating. I don't know. You know, I was looking at my map, you know, the POVs sometimes it gets a little confusing.
Is mic better from Katowice than it is here in Cologne?
Oh, is it all right? Yeah. Sound good?
But like, Astralis might do something here.
You
it
sound
does.
Great.
Yeah, in fact, I might let you take this, actually.
Look it out with an eagle.
Oh, all right, he turns it off.
Thank you.
Well, there's no time for this. The bomb's down in the smoke. They've done some damage with the kills.
You kind of want to die or survive, I guess, is the current lay of the land.
Save the orb, save the orb, save the orb, save the orb, save the orb. Okay. Lucky he saved the orb. It works in multiple different ways. I'll let you guys digest that at home.
Full stop.
Yeah, just peel
full
that
stop.
Off.
Wow.
The different layers.
Yeah, it's like an onion, that.
And look, now like we'll get the buyout.
93 damage there. Straight from the nade. Solid shot.
That used to be done so much. I know in Source, that used to be done all the time. You do like double or triple stack nades out that window in a second mid to stop people. But we were a lot quicker in Source. We definitely didn't default at this pace. But they are loving this four-man banana lane heroic. It's surprising Astralis haven't conned on and have gone for like maybe a quick
Fast
little zip
A.
up middle.
Yeah.
Because they're being able to throw their nades, set up Stown and Tessus to have their utility left over late. Cadian and Refresh can get all the way over. And meanwhile, the pressure is just on Shush, who's doing his darndest to dispel any early attacks.
But I guess Shush has shown just enough evidence that he can go Aggie apps that you are cautious when you want to take it when there is the B presence. Nearly got the sentence complete. 7-0, though, as we currently stand. All the weapons they could possibly desire. They're going for a bit of a 3-2 poke and prod here. Bubsky and Magis given the responsibility of returning top banana to the Astralis regime.
Well, they will get control. That Molly with the sandbag clear gives them everything they need to know right now for Astralis. But both teams limited utility. The smokes are in favor of Astralis if they want to go for an A piece. Got about 30 seconds remaining. They are lining up those smokes.
All right. This is the commit into three members of Heroic, and they got 30 seconds to dismantle the Prince. Shush dips into the apps defensively. Refresh dancing on the site with the crossfire established. Cadian will be there behind the smoke, and it's Shush actually taking that first fight. A perfect crossfire converted. It's only one left on the site. Poor Magis does hit some shots and should be able to get the bomb down with just a couple of seconds to spare. Man advantage for Heroic's retake, and they are the B players. Tassus and Stown have jogged on over, and a flash for the short side. Find nothing.
Molly for Pit here. Magis could be in trouble with this.
Oh, he's blind as well. Molly will force him into a wider angle. It's Tassus' responsibility to find him. Good shot. Magisk in the pit, always a problem. Cadian walking in, does neutralize the threat, can get that bomb now. Defuse one-on-one, Magisk 10 HP, and Cadian just in the nick of time. If he had a kit, there's one right underneath his toes, and that's 8. Ladies and gentlemen, by a Nat's wing, Heroic extend their lead even further.
Well, that's the closest yet for Astralis. They're very, very close to converting that one right there, and I think Magisk did a
Let's see if Astralis give it to them, or whether or not they want to surge up mid, as we discussed.
Oh.
Refresh, trying to be a problem. And that's Glaive's first of the round. First of the game. 10 HP. Might want to juggle that AK over to Bubsky, but Bubsky's busy right now, finding another up top banana. Tessus is his next victim. He's trying his luck, and wow, double with just the SMG. He's won this round for his squad, essentially. Unless Shush has got something to say about it. Does tag up Lucky just a little on the cross, and perhaps the nades could to pepper them further.
They should really save. Now they know that both are towards CT spawn as well here, so the pressure can be applied. More bullets put through the smoke. Nader down is Shush, and they are going to dip away.
Just in the nick of time.
I don't know if they'll be allowed to save this, though. Take a look. We already have one player of Dupree over towards Pier, and Glaive's still babysitting top of mid. So right now, Heroic are relegated to their own spawn. And now it just is, are they aware of that? Because Astralis, if they want, they could throw a body or two at this. I know that their economy isn't fantastic. I know that this is their first round on the board here, but they can break Heroic if they take away a couple of guns and a couple of rounds. Bomb goes off, first for Astralis. This is the problem with the derbies. You just can't say the Danes. Or I guess you could say the Danes, and then you guys have to guess who we're talking about.
I prefer that second option.
Okay. Well, did you notice with Bubsky here? I want you guys to look at the little details. Because Bubsky sits with his knee up, right? He sits with one knee up, or he changes his posture from time to time, but he also looks like he's quite the arm gamer. Mm. Because if you saw him just then, his monitor was shaking because the webcam was shaking, and that's where the webcam sits.
Spoilers.
So, yeah, he's quite the animated gamer right there. But let's get back underway. Heroic into the purchase once more. A little bit of money left over for the likes of Cadian and Shush for a buy in future rounds, but this has already been chipped away at our Astralis. Two players, about 50 HP just off the utility usage alone. They have three players just sitting on B here, Heroic. It hasn't been the four come throw nades and then two dip away to play the other bombsite. It's actually hoping that Astralis are going to hit that B bomb site quicker. And now this is where the mind games come in. Working on control here, so have got Stown out towards the sandbags. He's just dropped his smoke. So
very early.
Yeah, he's going to have to hold this B bomb site with no utility whatsoever.
They really are expecting an A. Like Cadian returning, dropping all of his util already. They're really hoping to have channeled them off the back of this half wall smoke. It's not the case. And bullets and steps will be heard. Tassus is called upon.
Yeah, and Tassus rotating over only has a smoke as well. So they've at least drawn him back out of position.
Ooh, this is a very quick rotate.
They've gambled as well. Yeah, Cadian's here as well. So it's going to be A.
So you got refreshed, tested again. He's had a great start here on Inferno. He's been spotted out. Does well to find one. I can't quite believe he did. And now Shush, multiple targets, way too much. Overwhelmed, the site is Astralis's. Cadian unable to contribute. The smoke will obscure his vision. 3v3, though, as the bomb just being repositioned. Bubsky opts for a safer plant. And that's all of Astralis's smokes.
Two through apartments. Is Stan going to go with him?
You'd love Tessus to draw some attention. Like, if Bubsky somehow starts looking away.
Cadian almost has to swing out here early to draw attention to give the avenue for Tessus to come and attack and Stown as well. This is a hard retake.
Yeah, it is not easy.
I feel like they're just saving.
Like, saving to contain?
Yeah, they're just going to try and do damage on the way out the door here. The bomb's already way too far ticked to go for this now.
They have to save in that pit. Damage inflicted and everything is lost. Bubsky and Dupree happy to keep hold of what they have. Okay, you can see there was some sort of game plan there from Heroic. Didn't quite go to plan.
And then they will have to either take a save or operate with saved rifles going forward. That's going to be the story of round number 11.
That's the aggression. Stown throws it down range and succeeds onto Bubsky. Matches caged by the flame, and as he peeks out, eliminated. Lucky even under scrutiny as well. That is quite the start for Heroic. Right back in the saddle. Yeah, this is an Aggie one from Cadian. You're not ready for that if you're Dupree.
That's so weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
You'd be in the T clearing that line coming out mid.
With your back turned to the typical AWP line that's smoked.
Yeah, it's a rough one right there. And this is a bit of a retake setup that's now been formed over towards B. Glaive peeking on in. Has Lucky not too far behind. Not even going to smoke. Just going to go contact here. And that is perfect. Into Stown. The boost is still in play for Tassus. And he's going to get flashed forward. See you later, Lucky. Take that M4. That's going to be 9 now as Heroic do respond after the 2. Having a quick little look around, just so people who, if you want to check out all the games, live.proleague.com, that's the link. It still works. You can find all the links for the different streams, or you can add a B or a C at the end of the current URL that you're watching on Twitch. Just for the map pool for the Vitality Spirit game, Dust 2, Mirage and Nuke. That's a very, very handy map pull for Spirit to maybe pick up that win where there's really nothing on the line for either team in that game. And Bad News Bears versus Ents, Overpass, Nuke and Mirage. Bad News Bears picked Overpass.
Well, they're trying something different, but it's the same result. Heroic given the gift of a double. And look at the surprising util. Glaive gets chunked by a nade, swung on by the Tessus. Dupree caught a chunk as well elsewhere in apps. Oh, and this one's a quick 10th for the Heroic boys. I mean, I wanted to talk about the previous round, just watching it in the replays. You could see how well-intentioned all of their util was. Like, Staun clears the close half wall, like left side of Banana from his POV, while the Molly stops anyone from having any sort of voice in contesting with him. Like, they isolate two 1v1s in a place you wouldn't think was possible, just by virtue of their pop flashes and Molotovs.
It's so crazy. Like, the Banana utility, if you really do start taking a look at it and all the different formations, there's intent behind every single different one of them. It's not just, oh yeah, this round I'll Molly logs and you Molly deep, right? There's a reason for that. It's right, oh, okay, we're going to do that, and then we're going to make sure we have a couple of fallen flashes. We're going to double nade close so then swim on that position. Guys are A, we want you to throw a deep mid Molly so they can't pick us from T stairs. Like, there's, what are you meant to do?
I mean, from what we just watched there, you just saw Astralis preemptively smoke half wall.
Here we go again. Glaive onto a Deagle. AKs for the rest. Refresh denied any aggression out that second mid window. And this is a standard setup now. So we've got three towards A, two towards B. And the very hyper-mobile Heroic continuing to move around the map. Tessus with a half wall. Oh, that's a nice little combo.
Yeah,
to do.
Not bad, that's it. You can throw that very safely with your feet on the floor.
Molly didn't burn, so either that was on their smoke that was thrown towards top Banana or his own. Oh, and just when you think you've got a bit of room to work with, the nades come in, and Bubsky down to half HP.
Even Cadian starting to float. Astralis have yet to commit, make their decision. Dupree in his comfortable apartment. And oh, Staun is flirting with some aggression here, and oh, caught slipping. Bubsky assuming Magisk had the push. And it's resulted in a commit here from Astralis. They are starting to swing on in. Cadian's AWP ready for the first. A pop flash for the pool fight. Glaive's beret hard to pluck. Lucky's into the site. They haven't checked Tessus. And Trigger Discipline enabling him to at least have something. Dupree clears him. Oh, and he's going to be frustrated about that one. You can see in the cam. They got anything left to say about this one? Refresh and shush. No fights given. Lucky's the first to strafe on out. Dupree ready for contact. It's easy as that, Lucky. A triple kill into the site.
Tessus is going to be so tilted because I'm pretty sure that the conversation in that moment was, hey, Tessus, bait me, right? Because he could have swung at any point to help Cadian during that fight. But the fact he's let Cadian go down, he's basically playing spoiler to win the entire round. So Tessus not getting anything done here. Yeah, that is the round right there. There's no conversation about that, but the money's still there. Heroic can buy. We'll get back underway here. 10-5 on the half. I think Astralis will be happy with that, considering how this one's been out the gates. It was an 8-0 start for Heroic. Two consecutive. A bounce back from Heroic, and here we find ourselves at 10-3. This is a very important round. If Astralis win this one, they can walk away with that 5 on the half because there's not going to be any money. It's only 1,900 loss bonus for Heroic next round. So whatever they have right now on the left-hand side of their screen, plus the kills they get, plus $1,900. That's all they'll have to opt and work with for the final round of play. But things have definitely slowed down a little bit here. There's no Staun double kill within the first 10 seconds of the round, and utility being exchanged as well as bodies because they're changing crews.
Yeah.
Yes. Shift workers over
like on the oil rig, yeah. The lifeboats have brought them in. Take the other boys home. Get their rest and relaxation on A. You think. Little do they know. Astralis fans might want to close their eyes and not read
that. Yeah, don't read that.
Don't read that.
Don't read that.
It looks like Snappy and the boys are back to their old ways.
Just think that this is a Danish derby.
Danish derby.
That's all it is.
That's all we care about.
Don't worry about anything else. Shush is about to be tested.
He's got at least two here. Magisk is first victim. Glaive's not handling any of it. It's Smoke deployed a minuscule gap. Cadence is working with much and very
big shot.
Quick from Bubsky. He had a tiny sound cue to work with. And it seems like Heroic, well aware of the financial decisions Chad has outlined, are going to pull the ripcord.
Well, let's quickly do some maths for him.
Go on.
Refresh can drop a Famous in the next round, or maybe they want to operate with an MP9 so he can play up close and personal. And then for Shush, if they want to keep him anchoring over towards his apartment's position, MP9 is fine for him. Or if he wants to go something a bit cheesy, he could go a shotgun, just gonna make his life a bit more difficult on the retake.
Yeah. And of course, don't forget A² plus B² equals C².
That's true.
And there's 180 degrees.
Did we ever find X?
Triangle, right? There's 180 degrees in a triangle, yeah.
Depends on the type of triangle, isn't it?
Well, Chad, I think I'm pretty sure it's always 180. That was what the whole point
was.
I think that was what Pythagoras was talking about.
I don't know. I just, you got right angle triangles, you got isosceles triangles.
Yes, there are different types. I would never dispute.
You've got cumulus clouds.
Those are a type.
I remember learning about the clouds.
Cumulus and what else? Nimbus?
I think Nimbus is from Dragon Ball Z.
Well, I swear, you don't just pluck that word out of thin air. That's a real cloud.
Smix has a cat called Nimbus, I think.
Is that based off of the Nimbus 2000 Quidditch?
Is that what they named it in the Harry Potters?
Yeah, well, one of them was, yeah.
J.K. Rowling. All right, well, it is a Famous and an MP9, so...
It's Latin for rainy cloud.
Nimbus?
Yeah.
Okay.
Last round of our first half of Astralis' map pick, and we're off once again to the races. This time, they've managed to evade all of that pesky nade damage, and... Pop flash. So we are going to be seeing Deep Smoke, Close HE, Pop Flash, everyone's anti, and Magis counters the swing. More than just counters. Bubsky rocks the boat further in favor. Tess is committed to this off angle, and it does enable him to beam down one, reposition as well. That's Brave, dropping his util to survive. They can't disrespect his smoke with the molly there.
Dupree's taking A during all of this.
Yeah, and Refresh still not convinced that he's not necessary on A, and they're coming towards him.
Oh, he needs two here at least.
He needs to have a multi-kill. Element of surprise compulsory. They're taking the bomb through apps. He's starting to piece this puzzle together.
Sneaky beaky.
Yeah, and they're just maneuvering through.
Wait, they're dropping back towards B. Just the sound cues alone?
Sound cues, yeah. Refresh's got nothing to
report. Oh, Tassus has left as well. Dupree's owned him.
Yeah, this is huge. Refresh has found Dupree and has nothing left to report.
Sector clear, Tassus.
Run! Knife is out. He hears the smoke. It only confirms their suspicions. And they're going to be coming in from two very different angles of assault. Going to strafe in. Got to be brave. Close that gap as best you can. The bomb's still not down. 25, Tassus. He's not going to go ahead of his teammate, is he? Refresh to clear banana side.
Against an AWP. Oh, it's an AK, never mind.
Glaive on poolside. New box clears first, big find, and it's a problem now. Lucky caught with his head turned and the smoke pulled. He's got info, knows one CT. Reacts to it, Glaive just in his blind spot and on the fountain.
Oh, what?
From Refresh, he could do it. He really could, Glaive denies. Was it 8 at one point?
Yeah, it was 8-0, and then 2-0. Return, and then, yeah, a bit of back and forth towards the tail end. So 5 is actually pretty damn good, all
it's
things
workable.
Considered.
And I'm sure Astralis, in hot pursuit of a quick frag, they've found it with aggression up banana, and that's going to spur Refresh and the entire squad
He's
into an
coming.
Execute, but he hasn't stopped. He's showing no signs of slowing.
Fight or flee, that's the question. Either way, they're forced into Lucky.
Yeah, Shush has clawed something back for the boys. He could even find another here if Bubsky denies very quickly. And it leaves them in a bit of a rattled state.
This is weird.
Yeah.
So Dupree's been able to find himself in T House. And then back over towards the B bomb site, we've got Glaive, who was the guy T stairs a moment ago. So this is odd. They will have to deal with Glaive. Where are they?
They've run past him.
This is just, this is Heroic.
It's very heroic.
You know who you're watching.
It's very on trend. And they have maybe even found a frag. Hang on, Bubsky's in library.
And they know where he is, and they're charging him down. They got plenty of time to play between these two bomb sites. What is going on?
If they clear him,
bro. If they clear him.
Yeah, not gonna happen. Caden's got a chance, though, on a quick block first USP 1v1, and he's managed to at least find it, steal
it. Not a lot of bullets left in that, though, Alex. Only 8 in total.
That's all he needs, mate. All he needs.
I guess it is all he needed.
Yeah, technically. He didn't have to really pull the trigger again.
No.
So. What do you make of that?
It makes sense for who we're watching.
Yes.
Yes. Look, we know that Glaive loves to run down banana, and he's done exactly that right here. activating himself in a big way. He was quite quiet in the first half. But yeah, you could just see how odd it was. You know, Shush jumping out short behind a guy with the Glock in the back of the head in the first 15 seconds of the round. Glaive fighting from T-Stairs.
You got Dupree at T-House. Great counter-aggression utility. Arcadian might actually render them a frag. He's got more than a frag. He's got an MP9 and Dupree down as well on his peak mid. Ooh, Astralis, alarm bells start to sound. Oh, the little early on the Molotov. It doesn't lock the CTs in or out.
If they go now, it's just one player towards Pit, and that's Bubsky right now. He's starting to float forward.
It's going to be in the right place. We need a huge spray down. It's on the cards, but Shush denies. And all of that weaponry now falling into enemy hands. Astralis are going to feel very hard done by as this round very quickly slips through their fingers.
And it's the two best guns as well that have been taken. The M4 and the Bloody Org. That is a horrible place to find yourself in right here, right now.
And let's recap how we lost them.
So Refresh boshed, I think it was Dupree top mid, right?
Bonk,
yeah, and then the banana control right there. So they extinguished to fight for control. So that's that car Molotov I'm talking about. So if the T's throw that, if you want to push through it, you have to extinguish. You either have to extinguish because then there's no falling back, right? So it went for the extinguish. And on the second round, you're not going to have all the same utility unless you all go MP9s like you would on a full gun round, right? We need to have the mollies, the smokes, the HEs, the flashes to facilitate that. And with the buy, I want to say pretty even at that point. Okay, okay, okay. They're actually pushing in for all the guns. They did take them all. That is wild on the chase as well, completely obliterating Astralis. This could have turned into a round with a Famous and a UMP and then maybe a couple of Deagles on the side with some smokes that could be interesting and a whole talking point. But now they're just going upgraded pistols, a couple of HEs. Bubsky's the only one getting Kevlar. Wow, all right. This could be the turning point right here. If Heroic keep this clean, they're going to get another round next round against just pistols like this. They clean up both of those. We're talking 13-6. They win the next gun round.
You don't see people going for those kind of hunts, do you? I mean, no. Certainly.
Not with the Aug as well, you know? Yeah. You think, oh, we'll hold on to that. It's a prize pig.
That'll do, pig. That'll do. You seen Babe? Did that make it across?
Yeah.
That made it across?
I think it was shot in Australia.
Oh, is it an Australian jobby?
I think so.
Yeah, the Australian pig Babe. He didn't have an accent, did he?
I don't know. I think it was shot. Let me find out.
He was very British,
the
farmer.
Where was Babe shot?
Oh, that'll do, yeah, but pig. He's from the country.
The wife was Australian.
I don't know what I'm doing there. Sorry about that.
After 7 years of development, Babe was filmed in Robertson, New South Wales, Australia.
All right. So you probably had it first.
I don't know if we had it first.
I reckon Babe's actually Australian.
I don't know if the whole film... I know who you're talking about, though, as the...
The man.
The man.
He's been in lots of things.
Yeah, the man who's been in lots of things.
The man.
Also known as the actor.
Yes, that's the one.
Is it James Cromwell?
James
Oliver Cromwell.
Yes. Not Earl Jones.
No, not Earl Jones. And Magda. I don't know how to say her last name. But she was in a... For all you Australians who are watching it, probably about 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock in the morning right now.
So there's about 3 of them.
Oh, there's a couple. You guys all know Magda. She was in Kath and Kim.
Oh, right.
That's a good comedy. It's funny. Flawless. Absolutely flawless. Well, now you've already been foretold what's going to happen in this round. More of the same. But I don't know if the outcome will necessarily be that way. Let me get out of bloody Google. We don't need to be in there right now. We don't need to be looking into... Babe's a great movie, by the way, everybody. If you haven't seen it, see it. Watch it.
I think it's on my list.
Do you reckon it's aged well?
Oh, there's a couple of things that I was really surprised by when I returned.
Didn't age well.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, your recollection of it is just so different.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm trying to think, what old movies have I seen recently? I rewatched Kill Bill.
Indiana Jones didn't age fantastically.
No.
Some people will hate me for that.
I think if you watch it for what it is...
Yeah. Do you know what? I fought the Mummy. But then again, that wasn't really good when it was first out, so.
Yeah. Yeah. What's the actor's name in that?
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
No, that's...
Brendan Fraser.
Yeah. What's happened
George
to him?
George of the Jungle.
What's happened to him? What's happened to
Watch
Brendan Fraser?
Watch out for that tree.
When was the last movie you saw Brendan Fraser in?
Oh, he's had a bit of a tough time, I think.
He has. I think he's been pushed out of Hollywood.
Oof.
I think they pushed him out of the movie business.
because, well, he was the superstar of the movie business for a while.
Yeah.
He was what Dwayne The Rock Johnson is now. You know, I reckon Brendan Fraser would have been in 2002's Jumanji remake.
Oh, yeah?
I don't know why they'd be remaking it so quickly after the original, but who knows?
Was it the scarabs in The Mummy?
Yeah, there was a very haunting scene. I remember my young Alex watching where they crawl through your skin. Yeah, that got me good.
All right. Well, movie talk aside, thank you for reliving what is now probably close to 20 years ago.
There's some Zoomers in the chat that, like, when they recall their old favorite movies, it's like Shark Boy and Lava Girl.
Their favorite band's One Direction.
Yeah.
It's like, that's our Spice Girls.
That's their Spice Girls. Yeah. For sure. For real. Not even a bait.
No cap. Keeping up with the kids. All right. Tessus, Mac 10, rifles for the rest. No head armor for 4 out of the 5 Astralis members here. So let's see.
Lucky's going to hit him with a little cheeky Orcs play, I reckon.
All right, the big grin.
Through the half wall in 3, 2, 1. Oh, imagine. I am. Like, that was weird.
The premonition.
Come on.
The premonition.
Maybe I actually have superpowers.
Okay.
I haven't considered it before. Actually, it's not true. I had a period where me and my friend Sam believed firmly that we actually had powers. And because we both acknowledged that I could see his powers and he could see mine.
It was real.
It was indisputable.
Dupree's... No, that can't happen.
Yeah,
he was the only
10.
One with head armor. Dupree had head armor.
10, dude, and Glaive has responded through the smoke. Maybe it's not the end of the world. After all, a 2-2 split of their defensive resources does mean that Heroic will have a slight advantage on the execute. Lurk smoke dropped by refresh. He's actually returning with to join the pack. Short-lived, he's actually committing. Bubsky with a lot to do here. Lucky can float through the smoke if he's brave.
Oh, very brave.
Seems he is.
I think they think a fake might be on the cards here.
Yeah, the fact that Glaive's only just now rotating, the steps will, confirm their suspicions. Big chance, only the one from Bubsky leaves us in a 2v2. And bomb's safe. As is refresh as he tucks into pit, to power position. Mad just demonstrated that in our first half. And speak of the devil, he's just arrived now on library. Hard Glim, Trish is looking the wrong way, so it does all fall to refresh, which is so good, but not today. Glaive says play on.
Yeah, good round from Glaive right there. Big three-piece. I'm still blown away by that Dupree fight. Like, he was the one hitting a couple of nice shots in that first half, so to lose to Tessus in that moment right there, not the end of the world. We can see exactly that. The whole Lucky situation. So we could obviously, look, he's just caught in the middle of no man's land here, and Bubsky and Pit. I think Bubsky's clearly communicated what he can and can't cover, but this is one of the things where, as a Counter-Strike player, and I'm sure we've all been there before at home, when you plan your matchmakings, maybe you're in your pugs, you try and do too much, right? You understand every years ago, they have so much money, Heroic. They could full buy right now. They have gone 4 MAC-10s and 1 AK, and they are just going to full send this.
All right, up the guts, it will be an interesting pop. Bubsky's not sure what's going on. Neither is his teammate. Bit shaken as the commit comes through. They're hearing MAC-10s. Long is lost. A barrage of flashbangs and smokes arrives. Dupree can do nothing but spray the smoke, and they're wrapping into the side. Look at the mini-map.
Everyone's here.
This is going to be a bloody deathmatch. And so far, it's Astralis that are winning out. Nothing really to be said about these MAC-10s. They've taken the site fully. Now, looks like they want to get... Look at Stout!
Stout's cut off the rotation.
What's he doing here?
He has the bomb and the rotation.
And the whole Astralis team are on A. Hello, goodbye, Magic. If he gets lucky, there's something to be said. He spotted him out. It's the AWPer, though, and Lucky. Whew, saves Astralis from a sweaty brow.
That one right there could have been wild, but the whole round was wild. So we're still going to get another gun round of Heroic here, and I can understand they have a lot of rounds to play with to do that. I thought they were just going to rush B. I didn't realize they were going to go up middle, but that was they definitely had the utility there, but it was kind of what cards they were dealt, and they adjusted as it all happens. But if Stown didn't have the bomb in that situation, and Kadian did, Kadian could have gone all the way back to B, Stown could have covered off the rotation from CT spawn. What a crazy world that would have been. But now we're actually starting to get into a conversation. Astralis are in this. 13 to 8. Don't even know numbers anymore. And they win this one. Well, now we're cooking. I checked in the first half, by the way, and I forgot to say it, but at one point, everybody at Heroic had over 100 ADR with the utility. Not ADR, utility damage,
utility,
right?
Utility damage, yeah. So they'd all done over 100.
Yeah, and right now it's like there's a couple of players. What was this? Stown's on 300 plus, 200 for Kadian, 240 for Tessus. So lots of utility damage there. Well, good read from Astralis here. We saw within the first half Heroic doing the same, playing with these CT-sided rotations, and right now there are three ready to receive a B execute. Bombs down towards the bottom of Banana. Still plenty of time in this round with just under 1 minute remaining. Smoke will negate any further plans they had of applying pressure, and they don't need to because that's, I'm sure, what they were looking to bait on out.
I love seeing teams just chopping and changing. Like, as soon as you see the util discrepancy, just casually walking across the spot. I've seen rounds lost when people spray the smoke as they're swapping.
Yeah.
It's a mad little mini meta we live in. 30 seconds, though, as the Heroic commit into just the two members of Astralis. You can see this util battle being played, and they have rotted the clock pretty damn well. The incendiary for the reactive hold, and he's actually dumped it early.
Oh, it's forcing him tight with the pull, Molly.
Yeah, they got 15 seconds. They can't really wait it out for too long. Magis forced forward, and Glaive ready to draw their attention, trying to bait them in. Isolated by the flames, it's just done well to thrive with a double. Oh, dear. And
need to
just
cover this.
Enough time. If Lucky does hit this warbang, it could all be over. Oh. Down denies with some great covering spray. And yeah, Astralis do disintegrate. Heroic, solid hold right down to those fine margins, just counting the seconds.
It did look like they had done enough there for a second, right, with just the delaying. But, well, knocked on over at the final hurdle.
Holding their nerve, like Shush did so well to get Dar double kill there. I saw the flames on the floor. He was working on a very small square of safe pixels.
Something funny happened. Stown's having a bit of a giggle there as he's looking to his teammates left and right. Everyone has a big smile on their face. So Heroic are in good spirits.
We missed the memo.
And now they're up to 14. So only two more rounds required. And if you caught the little highlight on your screen moments ago, not going great for the Bears, which, if you're an Astralis fan watching, it means it's not going great for you either. So if you missed the social media posts, if you missed the desk at the start of the day, we had Sedekus talking to Michal Slavinsky from League Ops about all the different outcomes. Heroic and Vitality are already locked on in. The third spot.
Astralis, first thing they're going to do, they're going to pick him up. They're going to hire at least three or four billboards across Copenhagen.
I bet Heroic are regretting that after what happened.
All right, well, the CT buy isn't great. It's glum for Lucky. He swallowed his pride and whipped out the baby orb. Glaive just down to the hand cannon as well as Bubsky as well. And speaking of those members, you can see that Bubsky and Lucky's Deagle and Scout combo is going to be tested by the Heroic players here in the apps. It's Tessa's first to have a look. Three-man setup. It's a potent crossfire short side. Who's going to blink first? Changing up the Astralis setup as contact heard on Banana. Takes the pot shot. Good nade to chip away.
They haven't cleared sandbags, so
they haven't.
That is a bit of an issue. 45 seconds now as well. If they want to pivot late A, Astralis will have the info, but that's about it. Coffin smoke. Yeah, it's all a fake. They know this is not going to be the B hit here. So A defender's on high alert right now. And this B flank can be fast.
Lucky. He knows he's got a timing. What a shot. And of course, what a target. Stown chips away at Tessus as well. Two conversions with two scout bullets. That's great from Lucky so far. Now he's lost the sight, Cadian to plant. We've got a 3v3 though for Astralis, and now with an upgraded glaive, they've got a shot, fresh looking the wrong way.
There was a kit on the sight as well.
They can go
for this.
Cadian goes for the most aggy of quick flicks. He's actually managed to neutralize Magis. Now Shush is the one to re-aggress, turns the flash, has a chance, and now 1v1. Oh. Dancing with him does eliminate Lucky. And man, the finest of margins separating these two teams. Lucky did so much in that round. He gave it all his all.
That got very, very sketchy. Very sketchy. That Cadian push to shore and the flick. Mm. What was that? I was not expecting that maneuver at all. Refresh got blindsided by that. He wasn't ready for the push up mid so quick. Whew. All right.
Yeah, I mean, this is impressive stuff. So does connect. It was the glaive that tagged him up earlier onto Stown for the one shot, but this is the 1v1, and Shush just has no issues. 19 frags alongside for the ride with Stown and Refresh closing in on their own 25s. They may not get the chance to unless this round goes the way of Astralis. Lucky already wounded. And they're just poking everywhere at the same time here. Fights to be found, fights to be won. Tessus once more. Magus down. That's two dead on A. Bomb's going B, though. Oh, and they just both turn their heads. That's a bit of a slip up the banana skin of Bobski. Catches them both slipping. Now the commit flying through. Smoke on the CT side. It's Lucky just hugging those coffins. What's he hoping to achieve here? The element of surprise. He chose not to fire a shot. So now as it fades, they may not be looking. Stown saves this teammate just before the trigger was pulled. And so it can still end here. No kits. They'd have to find it fast. There is a smoke to at least apply some pressure. Glaives walks into the crosshairs with a scorcher. And now Stown can finish it all. Very low HP on Glaive, can play the clock as well. Doesn't need to do anything fancy here. Stan will just play on the jiggle. Here's the pin. Suspects the full, and that's the end of Inferno.